practicing hot pursuit. Gets it to Murphy. Impossible angle. Murphy. GMA. HBA. I love that run, but that's a ripper.
What a goal.
Yeah, something to take away from a game that's been fairly dour between the Bombers and the Blues. Mark Murphy with what will be the GMHBA goal of the day. Don't think much will top that. Tom Morris is downstairs just priding himself away from the boring bar. Total Tools injury update.
Yeah, no injuries to speak of at the moment. Lots of rain, but Jacob Wiedering came back on about 5-6 minutes into that third quarter with a big strap around his head, and he's okay. But other than that, it's actually pretty good for both teams. No injuries in this weather, which is probably unusual.
Fantastic. Thank you for that, Chuck. Before we get to Kent Kingsley's Pagottings, just a quick look at the Fags minor 10s, please, Heath Buck.
Yeah, really cracking in the Blues. Probably should be further in front, Kent Kingsley. They've had 15 more tackles and got on top in that quarter in the clearances, winning it 10-5, winning it 8 overall. So getting really good use out of the centre by a big cruiser and a couple of midfielders. Gibbs has been fantastic with 27 touches. Should have had a couple of goals. Bryce Gibbs being off target with two behinds. Mark Murphy, the skipper, has kicked two really important goals. One in the second quarter, which put the Blues in front, and that unbelievable goal on the boundary line halfway through that third quarter. He's had 24 touches. Cripps is always busy with 18. Plowman's been fantastic on Fantasia. He's picked up 17 disposals, Lucky Plowman, and kept Fantasia just to 5 kicks for the game. Doherty, 14, 13 to piece to Curnow, and Patreski Seaton's been fantastic, kicked a great goal in that third quarter. He's had 13 touches. Heppel, 24, has been good. Watson, good, 24. Merrick has got into the game with 22, but no massive impact. Goddard's been nearly their best player, a goal from 20 touches, and Parrish, 17 and a goal.
Thank you, Bucky. Certainly kept our interest, Ken Kingsley, because of, I suppose, how tight the game has been, and the margin has never been greater than 8 points, or rather 10 points. Who wins from here?
Oh, look, I probably have to say Carlton. They're on top across the ground, stoppages, winning the ball. The only thing keeping sort of Essendon in the game is Carlton's inaccuracy in front of goal. 5 goals, 14, a few rush points in there too. But, look, I have to say, with momentum, Carlton gets over the line just, but it's going to go down to the wire.
Fantastic. Thank you for that, Kent, here for Goddings. Keep an eye on any Wombat Gully Plan Farm matchup changes. A nice mouth-watering one on the near side wing. There's Murphy and Heppel. The Seagulls have just seen the time and got it. It's time to head to the MCG. There'll be some free feed in around half an hour from now. And somebody will have 4 points. Will it be Essendon remaining undefeated and inside the top four? Or will the Blues pick up their first 4 points of season 2017? Umpire holds the ball along. Final term, thanks to Harvey Norman. He's Ben Casimilia on Carrick.
First goal, crucial. A 10-point margin might be tough to bridge in these conditions if the Blues can get it. Curnow, cruiser, quick kick to centre-half forward. Casbolt was there, spills to Thomas. He was knocked off the footy. Coming the other way was Ambrose. Thomas gets it again. Pulled off the kick by Kelly. It'll land 20 out. Silvani over the back. Casbolt crashes in. Out the back, Murphy a chance. Heppel in hot pursuit. Can Murphy keep it in the field? A plate goes off the ground. Cross the face of goal. It won't stay in. Thomas tracks it, but can't get there. And Essendon fans want it deliberate.
Another goal to the Suns. They led it by 10 points. Second quarter there against the Hawks, 33-23.
So, throw in. Just 10 around from...
Gee, the rain's heavy now.
Blues goal, yeah, it's...
You're right, Benny, a goal here.
Rain, cats and dogs, goal here, Blue it, Bucky, and you will be somewhat aroused. Cripps tries to get a kick, has pulled off it. Heppel kicks it outside 50. Do I come back? Do Sarakis did okay. Plowman coming the other way. Parrish comes in to lend some support. Danaher, fumble. Out the back, heard the voice of Heppel. Heppel did okay. Hand pass to Watson. Not great, though. Hit him on the bounce. Allowed Murphy in. He goes off the ground. Kicked it straight to Brown. He fumbled. It's been the theme of the day in these wet conditions. Over the top, Sylvain. That's been a good battle all day. Spills to Gibbs. Inside 50. Wiedering bandaged up. Can't mark. Did well, though. Found it on the ground at Curnow. Curnow around the corner. I'll get it to you a second. Kingy out the back, Casbolt, Ambrose it was, on the ground level, gives it to Kelly, and they might have heard crosses through Merritt.
Shorty goes to Brown, barely went 15, but the umpire paying the mark in the left back pocket. Yes, you would think they'd park the bus, Carlton, if they were to get 10 in front. Long ball from Brown, hooker couldn't mark. Leuenberger doing the roving, keeps it alive, boundary side. Hooker then banged it on his left boot to the winger, one-on-one. Doherty and Fantasia. Doherty had the better of that battle today, but McDonald, Tip and Woody. Wonderful tackle by Plowman, bringing him to ground. Fantasia with little soccer dribbling skills going on there. And then the tackle is laid on. Curno was high, not paid. Either way, it's advantage. As a free kick is now paid. Doherty, that was a terrible kick as he went to go short. Good pick up by Kelly, but in the fending off Petrevski-Seaton wants the footy. Petrevski-Seaton now with it at the edge of the centre square. He went with the outside of the left boot. The kick didn't go where it wanted. Oh, crossbatcher heads. Oh, there's a bomber down. Keep an eye on that. Casbolt gets to his feet. Kick now towards half forward. Oh, well played, Rowe. Danaher trying to turn him inside out, but Rowe can't get a handle on it. Now he shrugs off the tackle of Danaher and just bangs the kick forward. What's Weeder in front position and taking the mark in the dry? What do you think it was, the way he took it?
Hamlin hanger. Wants to go on the left. Looked a little ungainly. Petrevski-Seaton could have marked, didn't. White tries to tap it to the advantage of Silvani. Got front position. Silvani did okay. Wanted to fell to ground. Wanted high. Umpire said play on. So to Gibbs. Now spills to Curnow. High up and under. In the square. McGrath. Number one draft pick against Thomas. The number five draft pick. And the ball goes out for a throw-in. Five around from the Blues goal. They've done all the attacking in the opening 3 minutes of this final term. They lead by 4 points. 5-14-44. Essendon 6-4-40. Harvey Norman was set for a grand. Stand finish fourth quarter.
We've got a delay for a blood rule, I think.
Doherty.
Tom Morris, Doherty comes from the ground.
Sam Doherty, exactly right. And there's also a bit of a question mark over Travis Collier, who the doctor is checking now. Still on the field, but he got that heavy knock before and he stayed on, so I'll keep an eye on him as well. For
big meat Casbolt might have got him.
Just warm late gully, guys. Zaharakis has gone forward, being picked up by Marchbank. Pretty quiet game from now for the 150-yamer.
Ball got out the back of the boundary throwing. Merritt went out of the air. Got outside defensive 50, Danaher inside defensive 50, shrugged a couple of tackles, fed it to Watson, who gave it to Goddard, snapped it around his left shoulder towards the wing, back with the flight. White couldn't mark for Carlton. Here's Zaharakis firing a handball forward, but only into the path of Gibbs. Had it knocked away by Parrish. Rowe there to help out. Parrish wraps him up. Got a fresh area on the kick. Umpire said play on. Essendon fans wanted holding the ball. McDonald, Tip and Woody trying to keep it going for White. Good tackle. McDonald, Tip and Woody. The 2:43's come together. It spills the Crips and now Simpson.
Simpson. Umpire's letting it go, so they should. Tough conditions. Simpson to half forward. Cruiser. Didn't try to mark. Just flicked it out the back. Leg speed D to Thomas's first there. Goes off the ground. It was volleyed straight into the head of Falcon onto Kelly, who finds the ball on the ground. Did well, Kelly. Pressure and poise. Goes down the line. Wants Goddard, couldn't mark, but 3-on-1. Collier had a fumble, hasn't it been his day? Had a second fumble, tackled by Murphy. In goes Zaharakis, toe poke around the corner. What a fantastic. What's blue fans want deliberate. Umpire says throw it in. True centre wing, southern stand side of the MCG. Bathed in sunshine, nearly dark here.
Great experience play there by James Kelly in defence. Kent just showed all his experience with that forward thrust by the Blues.
Yeah, absolutely. And the Bombers are out then, but just a critical fumble there by Collier.
And we're throwing Kruenberger. Yeah, good play, Kruenberger.
It's a KGB agent.
Ball on the true centre wing on the outer side. Heppel tried to fend off Gibbs. Ball spilled out over the footy. Watson. Now McCready, the youngster, game number 3, bangs it inside, forward 50, diving. Thomas tried to trap the footy as he went to ground. Ball shoveled out. Here's Wright, handball away, didn't get to its target. Murphy, or free kick, surely. Was Casbolt a bit indiscriminate? No, not seen that way. Weedering, fresh airy. This happening 35 out from the Carlton goal. Danaher off the deck. Going to read the lead.
He's up his arm.
Surely it's a free kick for a hole. Dyson Heppel couldn't get out of his own way there, and in doing so, all the momentum was wide. I reckon he just came up a bit lame earlier.
You know, we're just slow when Simon Boyd outsprints you. It was extraordinary stuff.
Past him at a rate of
Oh, yeah, it was Usain Bolt stuff.
Simon White with the footy.
What was that?
About 70 from home. Top of the square, want to cruise it. Big double fist across the front for the Bombers as Merritt then goes off the ground. That is out on the full, and a free kick. Just outside 50 for the Blues.
We'll go to that man White. He's too far out to score. He'll probably just try and put it to the hot spot.
White inside 50 is the zero in favour of the Blues this quarter.
And I think we may have another blood rule.
Bagley?
This time it's Bagley. Umpire crosses the arms and suggests to Mark Bagley that he needs to exit the MCG and get that attended to.
Just while he's coming from the field, Bryce Gibbs, 29 disposals. He seems to have been able to handle his conditions better than anyone else, regardless of his disposals. Just his clean ball handling skills have been quite outstanding in the
week. Yeah, well, he was a number one draft pick for a reason. Like, he has always played 211 games coming into today.
He's just clean below his knees.
I just reckon the Blues have played the conditions better. Yep.
So White now, he'll push in off the fence. He does hoist it to that hot spot out the back. Casbolt, it spills to Curnow. Curnow finds it a goal, and he's kicked it. His team.
Essendon 6, 440. Harvey Norman, fourth quarter, and that might be, dare I say it, a long way out for the sealer.
Yeah, first goal was always going to be important, and 10 points is a big margin this weather, considering Essendon kicked 40 points for the game. So great front square there by Curnow, and a good snap in what was a perfect wet weather football goal.
Their last three goals, the Bombers have replied immediately within 30 seconds.
After Carlton won the centre bounce.
Yep.
Yeah, back in the middle. Cruiser winning the tap down. This time it's Goddard attacking it hard. Handball back for Heppel. Will the Bombers try and flick the switch now, but the kick goes poor. Under the chest of a blue in Doherty. To the wing he comes, looking for a marking option. Knocked away from Kerridge by Kelly. Petrescu, Seaton, the roving. Handball back towards the boundary line, and Plowman, rather Marchbank, who left it behind. And he's driven in a good tackle by James Kelly. Out of play, true centre wing boundary throwing. Palmer back onto the ground. Wiedering coming off the ground.
Only be a game out of the eight, the Blues, if they win.
It's been a good start to the season.
Boundary throwing.
Not home yet, Benny.
Ullenberger and Cruiser.
A long way to go here.
Cruiser dribbles a kick 5 metres. Picked up by Kelly, who dribbles it back another five. Cleaned up by Murphy, who then barrels one towards half forward. A couple of Blues collide with Casbolt, who's still down. Ball with Palmer. Inside forward 50. Palmer's kick. Pick it back with a flight. Couldn't mark. Got numbers back there, the Bombers. Outside of the right boot. That was a very smart kick. And now is with Gleeson. Gleeson sends a kick out wide, looking there for Zaharakis. Fisted away by McCready, but here's Danaher, front of the pack. Handball up. Collier with it. Little chip kick is not bad for Heppel. Is this for the quick reply? Heppel can send it into the pocket. The 150-gamer Zaharakis can steady, shoot, and he's missed everything. That is very un-David Zaharakis like.
He's killed Carlton on a number of occasions. Zaharakis in final terms. That was... A lot of Carlton supporters would have had their heart in their mouth when he got the ball there.
Mark Bagley back on the field, fellas, after getting his head strapped up again. Not the first one today, and probably won't be the last.
Interesting bandage arrangement he's got, Tommy.
It's interesting. Kick. The mummy returns.
What was the kick there coming from Marchbank? And the kick to the wing now for Carlton, cleaned up by Hurley. In kicking, Bagley was dumped. Now it's with Pickett. Trying to just palm it back into play was White. Brown shrugged off Palmer, and then a little drop kick. It's going to be effective. Goddard sold some candy on Simpson, and then on his right foot he snaps it only over the chest of Doherty.
He does, and Doherty, who's been a fantastic pickup for the Blues since joining from the Lions, one of 9 first round draft picks out there for Carlton. There might be 11 playing for the Bombers, all inside 50, but it's marked by Bagley, who's got extraordinary tape arrangement.
That pick we got Doherty with, Benny, was courtesy of pick 32 that we got for Sean Hampson, who went to Richmond.
Yeah, his career hasn't exactly taken off. Ball back on the wing, and there's that man Doherty again. He goes with a funny sort of ball around the corner, Cripps. Kelly had a handle on it, but coming over the top, he's got up with the fist, and the ball again has gone out for what must be a record number of stoppages, I would have thought. Throw in true centre wing, southern stand side of the MCG. Essendon, they trail by 2 goals. They've only kicked 6 for the game. We've gone 11 in this final quarter, thanks to Harvey Norman.
Goddard tried to get a handball up to Stanton. He could only get a kick to dribble about 3 metres. Gibbs over the footy, Stanton over the top of him. And a ball up, just 4 to the wing for the Blues out of side. They lead by 10. 11 and a half minutes gone on the Harvey Norman, Corio and Warren Pond score. Well, what do Essendon have to do to get things moving, Kent?
Well, they just need to get the ball going forward. They've just been getting it to half forward, but it keeps coming back out. They're really struggling to beat the Blues around the stoppages and get that free football away. The conditions obviously aren't helping.
Around the grounds, Kingy and Gold Coast lead by 22, 45 to 23.
Boundary throw in after Heppel's kick went off the side of his boot and dribbled out of play. Cruiser front position. Collier taken high. That's not hard. Umpire didn't see it the same as me.
Could be a weekend of upsets, really. I mean, go right back to Friday night with Sydney and Collingwood. Yeah. West Coast and Richmond here yesterday.
Frio.
What's Collier had on the Methags might attend statue? But he's got a stinker.
Yeah, I'll get him up in a minute, Benny. He hasn't been great. 13 touches, 10 kicks.
gives a handball into space. Palmer Howardson from him on his left boot anyway. Well played, McGrath, wrap him up. Off the ground goes Cripps inside 50. Attacking it was Hurley. Now soccer off the ground by Gleeson, but only as far as Rowe. 52 out from goal, kept his hand to put it onto the chest of Sam Kerridge, who will take all his allotted 30 seconds and go back and have a shot. Now, it was smart play by Rowe, could have pulled the trigger and gone long.
It's actually the best game of footy. I mean, I know the conditions have suited Sam Rowe today. It's very difficult for forwards, Ken Kingsley, but I haven't seen him as sure with his ball handling and his positioning as he has today.
Yeah, he's been great in combination with Marchbank and Plowman down there. They've been really strong, the defensive six for the Blues.
Kerridge playing game number 49. The boy from Mildura started at the Crows. From right on the paint at 50, he's hung that well out to the right. He may have even not scored. He hasn't. He's put it out on the full at the 13-minute mark, and Carlton's lead is still 10.
It's hard to believe he kicked six in a game, isn't it? I think it was in about his third game of those.
Yeah. Against Melbourne?
Yeah, against North Melbourne at Etihad Stadium for the Crows.
Were there that night, K-Rock, front and square. I think they came from a mile back. So Goddard, resultant free, pushed off at awkward looking ball. Heppel's there, was he taken? High umpire said no. McDonald tipping, we can't get a handle on it. Hooker tried to palm it to Merritt. Coming the other way was Gibbs, who's thrown himself in. And he's going to get pinned. For deliberate, was it?
Yeah.
So Merritt down the line, Zaharakis.
Like McCready, Benny. Really like him. He's he hasn't had much of the ball. He's done the job on Hooker. Hooker just the one goal from a free kick, and he's been really good, the youngster.
Been good. Hasn't been a night to remember thus far. 150 for Zaharakis. Just loping forward now to try to provide an option. Merritt pushed off it by Kerno. I think he's tagged him for most of the day. Ball on the deck. Murphy's tried hard. It was stolen by Gleeson. Gave it to Watson. He couldn't get a hand pass out. The six or seven players fighting for the Thomas William Sharon. An umpire, Troy Pennell, or as Bucky referred to him last week as Tony. Up on the win.
He's Tony now. He actually changed his name.
Kelly went off the ground now. Merritt does a little soccer instep kick towards the boundary line. Collier trying to keep it alive. Maybe it would have been better to see that as Murphy's now got it. Dragged down as he kicked, but bought 15 metres. Kelly knocked it away from Petrevsky. Seaton got a wonderful handball up to Merritt and then barreled it forward. Zaharakis can't get in the contest. Ball at the front of the pack. Hooker trying to keep it going forward. Parrish can share it with Stanton. Stanton had a fit of the fumbles there, but he's kicked away quickly. And he was dragged down to the kick, crucially, by Cruiser. And White was able to cut off the footy that was meant for David Zaharakis, who got him behind the defence. White, a high ball to the wing. Ambrose front position, Cruiser across the front, slides up his fist.
Good play by Doherty, just to tell Simon White just to settle down, take his time, no need to rush. Good experience by the former line.
Boundary thrown, this is a true centre wing. Members side, Carlton by 10, 15 and a half minutes gone in this Harvey Norman final quarter. There's going to be a free kick for a hold, and it's going to go against Danaher to Big Matthew Cruiser. So Cruiser with the footy. Gibbs and Danaher give each other a shove.
Right.
And Cruiser will look to launch a ball forward for the Blues.
He does. Watson's the only man.
Come on, contest, Carlton. Seriously.
What's even watching?
Terrible.
Watson, he just turned around, the ball landed in his lap.
I'd hate to think if they were 10 goals down, what Bucky would be like.
Oh, well, that was pretty ordinary, Kenny. I mean, if I was coaching, I'd straight out there.
Well, he's been pretty good. He hasn't barracked so far. Cozer on that hand.
He was disgraceful yesterday. I've never heard anything quite like it.
He had some feedback on the show in Concrete Twitter about Ian Cohen's barracking.
He was Peter Landy-like.
And he went very quiet late when the Cats started to...
In fact, he went chuck sort of call for about the last 15 minutes.
He did. Nothing's happened in this game while we've been discussing what happened yesterday. The ball's on the wing. Hand pass comes to Williamson around the corner. And that's a good mark taken by Pickett, who's had some chances today. Just hasn't been able to snaffle them in the wet conditions. He snaffled that one. He goes inside 50. But that's not a great kick. The only man there is Hurley.
Oh, just made a contest, Benny. Just get someone there. The ball was in the air for about half an hour.
So Bucky is starting to get a little bit of that.
When the game's up for grabs now for Carlton, this is 4 points they should get, and they're just...
Bucky's getting some tightening of valves.
Yeah, it's almost as if they think they've got it won.
Sorry, Bucky, I'm going to have to call over the top of your head because Bagley's taken a wonderful diving mark from the clearing kick at right half back. We'll let you go on with your invective a little bit later. Bagley, a long ball to the wing. Watson, front position, fisted by Plowman. Leaving it behind Wiedering. And Watson just trying to shovel it out. Here's Fantasia leaving it behind. McDonald, Tippin, Woody got it forward. Lewinberg. Here's Fantasia. Can he spark them? He bangs it on the boot. He'll like, just let this bounce out if they're smart here, Doherty. But in fact, it won't do that. Doherty fumbles near the boundary line. Time to recover. Swing a kick back towards the wing, but Lewinberg.
Yeah, good hands by some of the Essendon players in the wet conditions in the last couple of minutes.
Goddard, short, Keppel, can't mark. Juggled it. Now he's got trouble. Watson needs to scoop it up. Can't do so. Rowe had it knocked away by Watson. Going through was Williamson. Here's Fantasia. Open goal. This to bring it back to 4 points. It's hit the post. It's skidded into the fat net. And the margin is 9.
Well, he's had a quiet day, but had a chance then to get Essendon right back in it and just wasn't able to.
Simpson plays onto himself. Runs his full measure and then bangs it outside 50. That's a great kick onto the chest of Gibbs. He's still got to attack, Carlton. They can't just defend because they'll get overrun. He went to Murphy. He dropped the port. He's got time to find it on the ground. He was dispossessed by Goddard. That was good work. Tries to get it back off the ground. Gives it to White. White's in a hurried fashion round the corner. Coming up to meet it is Gleeson. They're just starting to get on top of the Bombers. Gleeson goes with a spiral inside 50. Fantasia there. So to Rowe. And in true Mick Schultz style, double fister out for a throw-in.
Gold Coast lead 48-24, four to go in the second quarter against the Hawks at Metricon.
So a throw-in, 49 around.
I'm worrying you.
From Essendon goal, a goal here would cut the margin to 3. Spills to Goddard, high up and under. Langford's there, so to Rowe. Carlton got the numbers at ground level. Can they work it out? Ripped off the footy was Doherty. Coming through McDonald, Tippin, Woody. Sold some candy. Round the corner.
Poor.
Misses. Right-hand side. And they're just starting to press the Bombers. In the shadows of the final siren. Margin now 8. 6-6-42. Carlton a 6-14-50. Harvey Norman. K-Rock fourth quarter.
Simpson with kicking duties. Nearly at 20 minutes and time on in this final quarter. To himself and then brings a broadcast side, wants Thomas, but Langford, big fist, spikes it out of bounds. Hits a stoppage for the Bombers. So, players will reset. About 55 around.
Darcy Parrish just working there.
From the goal face.
By himself.
Count with plenty of numbers back. Every player in the Essendon half of the ground. Boundary throwing. No clear winner from the ruck contest. Cruiser just banged it on the boot. 15 metres it went. Gleeson took them on. He's pulled off his kick. Petrevsky Seaton had it partially smothered by Gleeson. Ball squirted out towards Kerridge. He went off the ground. And then it's deflected off the foot of Jacob Wiedering. How stiff could you be if you're a Carlton supporter? And Merritt's got the free kick at true centre wing.
Merritt. What's he up to, Bucky?
Mary said 29 now.
That's a good one. I'm sure that was an intended target, but fell straight into the lap of Heppel. Now Heppel wants to switch. He does. Long ball to the former Cat Kelly. Kelly marks. He's got Parrish this way and that way. Dinks it in and Parrish marks. Oh, he should have marked. He didn't. He dropped the board. Has to give it to Ambrose floating by. His kick, Zaha Rakas, had a dirty day. Couldn't get a handle on it. So too Fantasia. He's ripped to Terra Firma. Rowe goes off the ground. That was good to Palmer. And they're out because Williamson, Bucky Man, got it. Holds it up. Back to Palmer. Sold some candy. Kelly paid cash. Palmer to the wing. Half forward. Hurley will track it back and be first there.
Here's Wiedering for company with the underground handball for Bagley. Bagley's now got some company in Casbolt, but sweeps the ball. Ambrose, McGrath steps inside the man coming towards him and then sends a kick long from behind. The fist came from Collier, but no, numbers with Carlton. McCready, clearing kick, came from Thomas, just banged it long and onto the boot, into the chest. It's taken by Cripps, and he just holds play up as we've gone 21 and a half minutes. Have they done enough, the Blues?
No.
Of course, Bucky, that was going to be your answer. Kick towards half forward. It goes through the legs of Casbolt and out of bounds. Boundary throw in. About 120 metres from home for the Bombers. They've got plenty of work to do. They need to jag 2 goals. They've only kicked 6 in the first 3 3/4. What are they going to do in the last 5 or 6 minutes here?
They need something, and they need it in a hurry. Played with all the pizzazz of a white button shirt so far, the Bombers. Hocking pushed off the ball by Murphy and he's actually pushed over the line for another stoppage.
So 25 points, Benny. The Gold Coast in front of Hawthorn. A minute to go in the second quarter up there at Metricon. So
Hawks staring
doing quite
down.
Well.
Hawks staring down, zipping 3 and then staring down the Cats. next Monday here at the MCG, Easter Monday clash. Hocking goes off the ground. First with Air Williams, and he'll do well, just disguised it. Had no intention of picking the ball up, just professional fumble and out for another stoppage. I don't know what those stoppage numbers are, but you'll be able to tell us those on the Fags Mitre 10 stat sheet.
Yeah, we've got 103 now. They've got the standing ovation.
103 umpires.
Style.
I thought I did see an umpire raise the hand just to the crowd as the tongue came up.
Back of the pack, the ball went. Neither Heppel or Merritt could take it cleanly. His Cripps like a bull, just banging it on the boot and onto the chest of Wiedering, who marks. Wants to get going, but doesn't need to, but he will send it long. Top of the square, Kaz Ball, can't mark. Hands of the pack, Gibbs to seal it, Gibbs to seal it. Across the face, so it will bounce, and it'll go out of bounds. Boundary throw in front of McGrath.
Mike McGrath.
He's also right.
He's going to be good. I mean, he's a number one draft pick, but he's 48,000, not bad, can you, for a miserable day in Melbourne.
Yeah, they've mostly under the bleachers.
Car park closed here at the MCG.
Well, back into play, Lurenberger winning the palm down. Front of the pack, Curno. Quick snap over his right shoulder. Has missed. And to behind, 9 points is the margin. They really need to roll the dice now, Kent Goddings, do the Bombers.
Yeah, they have to. Straight down the middle here. They've got a few minutes to kick two goals. But just watching Cade Simpson across half-back, the experience of 280-odd games, just directing traffic, calling all his troops back, just making sure all the S and loose guys are being picked up.
Kelly, long outside 50. They've got to move it quickly, the Bombers. Out the back, White, who's been pretty good today. And another professional fumble sees it out for yet another stoppage.
Lee Fisher officiating that one, Benny. Just used his...
White and Rowe, they're not exactly household names, but they've been pretty strong today. Both of them have certainly performed their role. Rowe's been great defensively, and White's tried to provide a little bit of attacking while doing the defending pretty well. Cruz has got it. He's battled hard all day. That's not huge.
Come on, boy.
Cripps.
Dangerous.
Kerno, I think it is, under the bottom of that pack. He's dumped. And we'll have another stoppage as Watson gives the ball back to umpire Lee Fisher as he helps.
33, Benny. For the Fags, Mitre 10 leading disposal went on the ground. Heppel, 30.
Cruiser, only as far as Hockey. High up and under, goes about 14 metres. Big fist from Cripps. There is Goddard. So too Collier. Round the corner. Collier's kick is well judged, though, by Marchbank. And you'd think now that the Blues...
We've got to be smart, kid. Don't you dare go across.
Marchbank. Love how Bucky's got a direct line to the Carlton coaching box. To half forward, here's Thomas at the front of the pack. Murphy, White, snaps a kick forward. Casbolt could... Oh, Palmer, what were you doing going off the ground? It's going to end up with the Bombers here. Kelly's got to hit a target on the way out. Doesn't. Hocking, though, the fist. Hooker the fumble at the wrong time. Then knocked it away. Only into the path of Plowman. Handball on the bounce. Curno turned the corner but didn't take the footy. Hooker, Collier, Heppel going to have some company. Oh, good hard from Plowman in terms of a contest. Collier, though, kept it alive. And now Danaher is scooped it out of play. Marchbank, Plowman, they've been outstanding. Now Rowe and Marchbank want to get involved with a dust-up with Danaher. Separate that. We'll get a boundary throw in.
Looks like Mark Murphy's got some severe cramp, boys, in that right leg. He's trying to get it out late in this game.
The total tools. Ball out the back. Gotta go. Bang. Inside forward 50. They got a number back. It's going to land on the chest comfortably of Doherty. And we'll hold things up for the Blues, and they just might be home.
Yeah, you think it's all over now. Can't kick two goals in this short period of time. Doherty just bangs it back. Up goes Casbolt, went under the footy. Cripps at ground level. He's got a couple of beat. Farms a hand pass to Curno. He couldn't get a hold of it. Going in was Hocking. Little touch to Parrish. Ambrose's kick was smothered. It's all scrappy play. Cruz is kicking about 8 metres. Thomas goes off the ground. Inside the middle of the MCG. Hurley's there. Got Silvani tracking him. Danced around him. Did well. Hand passes to McGrath. McGrath's a fumble. Got time to go and pick it up, though. Hand pass wide to Kelly. One last charge for the Bombers.
Kelly's checked the kick towards half forward, but a big double fist from Doherty and sends it towards the outer wing, and he'll pick up his own crumbs, a handle into space for Kerridge. He looks to go off the ground, bouncing ball, Gibbs, fumbled, sweep to handball towards Wiedering. Gleeson came hard, so did McDonald, Tip and Woody, lost his feet, then scooped it in, tried to go again, little toe poke from Wiedering, deflected off the shins of Kerridge towards the boundary line, and out of bounds, boundary throw in. There's a minute 23 remaining. I don't know about that being flashed up on the screen around the fence around the ground. I'm guessing the advertiser's paying good money for that to be seen. Boundary throwing, Cruiser from behind. Clock ticks. Curnow, you think they're home here. Murphy, a little kick around the corner. Right, handball up. Now it's with Curnow, Cruiser to seal the deal for the Blues across the face. He goes, Silvani dropped what he should have taken. And it's gone out of bounds. We're going to boundary throw and five around from the right hand behind.
So Blues are going to record their first win of the season. They will go 1-2. The Bombers will drop to 2-1. And this competition, it's as even as all get out this year. Anybody can beat anybody on a given day if you don't bring your A game. And Carlton really upset Melbourne last week, and today they're going to upset the Bombers. And in the final seconds, we've got another stoppage. Our 7 millionth stoptage. And it's been a rain-soaked Sunday afternoon here at the MCG. Cruiser has battled Leuenberg all day. They'll be sore tonight. Off the ground goes Heppel. It spills out to free kick. It's going to go to the Blues. It's going to go to Kerridge. Kicking in danger. Not sure the kicking in danger rule should be applied too strictly in today's sort of, this sort of conditions. But nonetheless, it's
actually nearly a free kick against Kerridge for sliding in if he'd actually caught Heppel's legs.
It can go both ways, can't it?
Yeah.
Kerridge, this one before, mind you, was from further out. They can kick it out the foot. So he gets a chance. He's just taking time off the clock. And he'll come in right on the final siren. And ice, what will be a memorable win for a young Carlton side that features Williamson, Marchbank, Wietering, among others. And he's done it. Carlton fans are aroused. They get to him. They've slogged it out against the Bombers, and they've slogged their way to 4 points. 7-15-57. The Bombers 6-6-42. Harvey Norman, K-Rock, fourth quarter.
Pushing all their numbers back now. I don't think they realise it's only, about 20 seconds
like that.
They've left two forward.
I actually don't think there'll be barely any play. In that final margin, it will be 15 points. It's the biggest margin of the afternoon. As Kerridge kicks the goal, his first of the season in his first game. Cruiser and Leuenberger in the middle. Gibbs would be fitting if he had it at the end. Cripps has his kick smothered by Parrish. It's all by the by, though. Kerridge dumped. Cruiser. Blues win the famous victory.